When the lockdown happened last year, I used my outdoor exercise time to explore a little of the bush in my area and to look for different rocks and clay samples that might be able to be turned into paint pigments. I had been wanting to make my own paint and had been gathering supplies for a little while, but I wanted to also create pigments in a sustainable way. I started looking for a paint mulling tool locally in New Zealand. I'd actually been looking on and off for a few years, but did not want to get one sent all the way to New Zealand from eBay or Amazon if I could find one here. Finally, I found a local glassmaker that had a few paint mullers in stock they were able to sell. The maker of this beautiful hand-blown glass muller is Flame Daisy, and I am so happy to have this tool to start my paint-making journey. At about the same time, I was researching medieval paints and pigments and learning how I could incorporate some of those recipes into my handmade palette also. One of the recipes was for eggshell white, which I found intriguing because eggshells are easy to obtain and also because at this point I did not have the tools to break up rocks before adding them to a mortar and pestle. So I started out by following the recipe from a book of secrets published in 1596. The earliest of these types of books was published in 1557 and was a translation from the original Italian book, The Secrets of Alexis of Piemont. To make chalk of eggshells. Take eggshells and let them lie 3 days in vinegar, then wash them well in fair water. Dry them in the sun and beat them to powder, then grind them upon a stone. I followed this recipe as closely as I could. After the eggshells had been soaking for 3 days in the vinegar, I was able to separate the inner membrane from the shell quite easily, leaving just the outer shell behind. I drained all the vinegar away into a glass using a coffee filter, then I rinsed the eggshells in water several times. After this, I left them to dry completely in the coffee filter. It took a while for me to get to the next step, as I did not have a pestle and mortar. I also realised that I needed containers for my homemade paint, so I went to the beach and foraged for some suitable seashell paint pans. Okay, so I've just given these a rinse in the sink. And they were pretty clean to start with because I rinsed them in the sea before I brought them home. So these are all dead shells. They didn't have any animals or little sea creatures living in them. They're just ones that were washed up on the shore on the beach. And what I was specifically looking for were little shells like this, or shells that were roughly this shape. So I've got a few kind of pippy or cockle shells. Here we go. And then a few larger ones just in case I needed them. But mostly I'm interested in ones about this size for the most part. Now over here I've got my jar which I have now filled with a bleach and water solution. It's very diluted. There's not much in there, but it should be enough to just clean out any bugs or bacteria and to make the shells nice and clean. So I'm going to put them in here for 1 hour. 1 hour. I'm going to put them in here for 1 hour. And that's also why I'm wearing gloves, because I'm just about to drop these little shells into this solution. So yeah, it should kind of clean the shells enough. The colours might fade a little. That's the only thing I read about the bleach bath. And some of the ones I've got do have quite sort of pretty subtle colours in them. So we'll see how we go. Well, this one's got kind of a lovely stripy shell pattern down the side there. So we'll see how much of the colour is left on these shells. And a kind of a lovely purpley inside. But yeah, we'll see how much is left by the time we get them out of their bleach bath. After the shells were cleaned, I moved on to the next step, which was preparing the surface of a glass plate for mulling. I salvaged the glass plate from a broken scanner, which, while not terribly heavy, was quite thick, and it also already had the edges pre-beveled and sanded. I cleaned the adhesive off the glass with isopropyl alcohol, and wearing a dust mask, I gently sanded the centre of the plate to create a better surface for the paint mulling process. Time I'd ordered a small mortar and pestle and it finally arrived. Eventually I would like a big heavy stone mortar and pestle, but this was all I could find to order online during the lockdown last year. I also figured that the eggshells would be very easy to crush and grind to start with in the smaller mortar and pestle. I made sure to get a pack of proper respirator masks so that I wouldn't breathe in any fine dust particles. The first thing to do was take a little of the treated and dried eggshell a bit at a time and start grinding it up in the mortar and pestle. I would like to preface this straight away by saying that I did not grind the eggshell anywhere near finely enough, but I will be going back and remulling this first batch of eggshell paint I made because remulling definitely helped the second batch. After grinding up the eggshell, I carefully tipped it into a tiny jam jar via a folded piece of paper. I love how these tiny jars look, Occasionally I get one or two of these to try different flavours of jam, and they are wonderful recycled as little containers for art and craft items. They look very cute on my shelf with all my other paint making supplies. I repeated the process several times, grinding up the remaining eggshell and putting it into the tiny jar. From memory, this amount of powder was what came from about 4 or 5 eggshells, and it made a surprising amount of paint. Now for the exciting bit, I actually got to try mulling my first lot of watercolour paint. I followed and modified a recipe by Pierre Fleur, working with what I had available. I will leave a link to Pierre Fleur's paint making video in the description below. Here is my supply list. Gum arabic, honey, distilled water, the pigment, a respirator mask, and also gloves for when things get messy, a mulling tool, glass plate, palette knife, measuring spoons, containers or paint pans for your finished paint, in this case I was using the seashells, and glycerol or glycerin. I found it difficult to find glycerin locally, but we did have glycerol, and I found that they are both names for the same molecule. Thank you. Once I had all the ingredients on the glass plate, I started mixing them together with the palette knife. The mixture was very sandy at first, but it started to come together. I added a little bit more distilled water. This helped immediately, but I wished that I'd had a bigger palette knife. At this point, the paint was starting to have the consistency of sandy cake frosting. Mmm, yummy. But it was very exciting as the mixture was starting to somewhat resemble paint. When I was satisfied that all the ingredients were thoroughly mixed, I began to use the mulling tool. It was at this point I could see just how grainy the texture was, but I persevered. I mulled the paint in circles and in a figure of eight motion. Then I scraped the paint back to the middle of the plate and started mulling again. The more I did this, the better the mixture got, and I added more water occasionally to help out. At this point, I also put on some gloves as it was getting quite messy. I was very pleased with the glass plate that I scavenged from the scanner, but it was not quite heavy enough and tended to move around a bit. I think I will use a non-slip mat under it next time. I finished up mulling the paint as it was about 11 p.m. at this point, and then I added blobs of paint to the little seashells I'd collected. The seashell pans with the rounded blobs dried very evenly and with hardly any cracking. The pans where the paint was a little thinner and more spread out ended up cracking quite a bit as they dried. One small lot of pigment made quite a few little seashell pans of paint. I think that the greater surface area of the paint exposed to the air in the shallower pans meant that the paint dried more rapidly and caused the cracking. Even so, I was very proud of my first little set of homemade paint pans. I hope you have enjoyed this first video all about my paint making adventures. In the next video in the series, I will be making my first paint from a piece of mudstone that you saw at the beginning of this video. I will also be creating a painting with the paint that I make. Have a fantastic day, thanks for watching, and I'll be back again soon with another video. Bye!